In this video, you will learn how to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss. To understand degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss, first of all, you must understand what is meant by degree of freedom. So in this video, you will first learn what is degree of freedom, then what are the different types of displacements available at the joints. What is the definition of degree of kinematic indeterminacy? What is kinematically determinate structure? Then we will solve some examples to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss. Actually, it is very easy to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss. But to understand degree of kinematic indeterminacy, first of all, we must understand some concepts. So first of all, let us see what is meant by degree of freedom. Let us consider this beam. Under the action of the load, there will be some displacement of every joint. There are two joints, A and B. At A, there is hinge support. At B, there is roller support. So whenever we apply certain loads on this beam, there is displacement of the joint. So what are the displacements? That is, translation means movement in vertical or horizontal direction, or rotation of the joint. So in this case, there are two rotations, theta A and theta B. And there is one translation of the joint B. We know that at hinge support, there is no horizontal displacement, there is no vertical displacement, but rotation is possible. So what is meant by degree of freedom? Degree of freedom is equal to number of unknown displacement at the joint. So the degree of freedom is defined as the number of unknown displacements at that joint. Now in this beam AB, at hinge support, joint cannot translate, but it can rotate. Hence here the degree of freedom is 1. Whereas at joint B, it is a roller support. So at roller support, the joint can translate in horizontal direction as well as it can rotate. Hence, degree of freedom at roller support is 2. And therefore, in this case, total degree of freedom for this beam will be 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. Sometimes, to make the analysis simple, we neglect axial deformation of the structural member. In this case, this is the deformation in the axial direction. So if the axial deformation is neglected, so joint B cannot have the horizontal translation because the beam is inextensible. So there will not be horizontal translation at joint B, so we can neglect it. In such case, at each joint only rotations are unknown. And therefore, when we neglect axial deformation, degree of freedom will be 1 plus 1, 2. So, in calculation of degree of kinematic indeterminacy, there are two types, that is considering axial deformations and neglecting axial deformation. So, in this case, if you consider axial deformation, degree of freedom of this beam is 3, whereas if you neglect axial deformation, there will not be horizontal displacement here and degree of freedom will be only rotations at A and B, 1 plus 1, 2. So therefore, we can calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy considering axial deformation and neglecting axial deformation. But remember that the value of or the magnitude of degree of kinematic indeterminacy neglecting axial deformation is always less than degree of kinematic indeterminacy considering axial deformation. So if you want to understand this degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss, so watch this video very carefully. So to calculate degree of freedom of structure, first of all we calculate degree of freedom of each joint in the structure, and then we add it to get degree of freedom for that structure. To calculate the degree of freedom of structure, first of all you must know how many possible displacements are there at the joint, because degree of freedom we calculate just by adding number of degree of freedom at every joint. So you must know what are the possible displacement at the joint. So this table illustrates what are the degree of freedom per joint and what are the possible displacement at that joint. For example, if you consider plane truss, so for plane truss our basic assumption is there are pin joints. So at every pin joint, what is the degree of freedom? It is 2. And what are the possible displacements? U and V. U is horizontal displacement in x direction, whereas V is displacement in y direction. So in case of plane truss, only 2 displacements are possible, because the joints are pin joints, they can rotate, and therefore only 2 displacements are possible, U and V. So total degree of freedom for pin joint of plane truss is 2. Now let us consider space truss. In space truss, translation is possible in x, y and z, all the 3 direction. So here U is translation in x direction, V is translation in y direction, and W is translation in z direction. So for pin joint of space truss, degree of freedom is 3. Remember that in case of truss, there is no rotation. Next is rigid joint of plane frame. So in case of portal frames or plane frames, degree of freedom is 3. Remember, here also it is 3 and here also 3, here also 3. But possible displacements are different. In case of truss, only displacements are possible along the longitudinal axis, that is translation, U, V and W. Whereas in case of plane frame, the joint can displace in x direction, in y direction, and there is rotation in z direction, because theta is around the z axis. Z axis, we are considering x axis is horizontal, y axis is vertical, and z axis is towards you. So therefore, the rotation is around the z axis. So for plane frame, there are degree of freedom per joint is 3. And what are the possible displacements? U means translation in x direction, V is translation in y direction, and rotation in z direction, around the z axis. In case of grid, the degree of freedom is again 3, but the possible displacements are rotation in x direction, rotation in y direction, and translation means displacement in W direction. W means Z direction. Now, rigid joint of space frame. Degree of freedom for space frame per joint is 6. What are those possible displacements? All the translation in along all the axis and rotation along all the axis. So U, V, W is the translation along X, Y and Z axis respectively, and theta X, theta Y, theta Z are the rotations about X, Y and Z axis respectively. So you must first remember this table to calculate kinematic indeterminacy of any type of structure, that is plane truss, space truss, plane frame, grid and space frame. After understanding what is degree of freedom, let us understand what is degree of kinematic indeterminacy. Actually, degree of kinematic indeterminacy is the total number of degree of freedom at all joints in the structure. So degree of kinematic indeterminacy is nothing but degree of freedom for that structure. So thus kinematic redundancy is equal to the total number of unknown joint displacements. So what we do, we just count what are the possible joint displacements are there in the structure. So there are two types in degree of kinematic indeterminacy, as I told you, that considering axial deformation and neglecting axial deformation. Normally, the structures are kinematically indeterminate, but there are few cases in which kinematic indeterminacy is zero. That structure is called as kinematically determinate structure. So fixed beam is a kinematically determinate structure since at each fixed joint, no translations as well as rotations are possible. You know that at fixed end, there is no horizontal displacement, there is no vertical displacement, also rotation is not possible. So fixed beam is an example of kinematically determinate structure. For fixed beam, degree of kinematic indeterminacy dk is equal to zero. So such structure is called as kinematically determinate structure. Now let us understand how to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy for truss. Degree of kinematic indeterminacy is denoted by dk. So now we will solve some examples to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy for truss. Before we start numerical example on how to calculate kinematic indeterminacy of truss, we should remember few points related to it. We have already studied what are the possible displacements for plane truss. So here we are solving problem on plane truss, degree of kinematic indeterminacy for plane truss. So for plane truss, at each joint, U and V displacements are possible. So remember this. Second is, there are supports to the truss. There can be hinge support or roller support to the truss. So for hinge support, U and V displacements are not possible. So their degree of freedom is zero. For roller support, U displacement is possible. So at roller support, degree of freedom is one. So we will write, while solving the problem, we will write the degree of freedom at each joint, and then we will add all the degree of freedom at the joint to get degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss. So let us start with a simple example. Calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy dk for this truss. As I told you that for each joint, U and V displacements are possible. U means horizontal displacement and V means vertical displacement is possible. So at each joint of the truss, the degree of freedom is 2. At hinge support, U and V displacements are not possible. Therefore, here degree of freedom is 0. At roller support, U displacement is possible. Therefore, degree of freedom is 1. So here at this joint, 2 at every joint, right? 2 at every joint of the truss, then 1 at roller support and 0 at hinge support. So what is the total degree of kinematic indeterminacy in this case? It is 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, 1. So total degree of kinematic indeterminacy for this truss is 9. Let us consider another example. As I told you that for each joint, you have to write 2, for hinge 0 and for roller 1. So here it is 2. Degree of freedom U and V is the displacement. at the joint. Here also U and V are the displacements. At roller support 1, at hinge support 0. So if you add it, you will get degree of kinematic indeterminacy is equal to 5. So as I told you that degree of kinematic indeterminacy is nothing but counting the number of freedoms at every joint. So for truss, write 2 at every joint and write 0 at hinge support and 1 at roller support. So here there is 1 hinge support and 2 roller support. Just count it. You will get degree of kinematic indeterminacy. So in this case, degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 8. Let us consider one more example. Just write 2 for every joint. Then we know that here it is 1 and at the support it is 0 at hinge support. So count it. It is 11. So degree of kinematic indeterminacy DK in this case is 11. So whatever may be the truss given to you, in case of plain truss, you have to write 2 at every joint. At hinge support, you have to write 0 and at roller support, you have to write 1. So in this case, degree of kinematic indeterminacy is 10. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, this is 8, 9 and 10. So degree of kinematic indeterminacy for truss, this truss is 10. So in this video, we have discussed how to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss, what is meant by degree of freedom, and we have solved some numerical examples on degree of kinematic indeterminacy of truss. Now remember one important thing, that is there is no relation between degree of static indeterminacy and degree of kinematic indeterminacy. Degree of static indeterminacy is in terms of reactions and internal forces developed in the structure, whereas degree of kinematic indeterminacy is related to joint displacements. So degree of kinematic indeterminacy is important term while solving the problems using displacement methods, whereas degree of static indeterminacy is important when we solve any example using force method. In next video, I will explain you how to calculate degree of kinematic indeterminacy of portal frames. I hope you will find this video useful. So stay connected to watch more videos on structural analysis.